can hear the sound of rain. It's about to rain. Oh, let it rain, Jesus, let it rain.
Some of us finish our race poorly or never finish at all. People have lost the ground that is ahead of them just because of the surrounding. Men of God take whatever is good for them and they give to the Christians who are following him the bad things. It is not my portion. I refuse that. Your help is not in the life of experts. Experts may fail, but God can never fail. The Bible says all the books will be open, and every man will be able to tell what he did in this world when he was still in the body, whether good or bad. The storm will come out, the storm will perish, the storm will be calmed, because they are preachers. The men forget what happened yesterday, forget how many people are dead, and focus on your calling. Are you known by God by your name? Does God understand your name? No one was made in vain. You are made for a specific purpose. It is so ignorant to let God go out of our place of worship. It is so foolish to let God be locked out of his house. Listen to the voice of God. Is he the right person to get married to you? Is he going to help you accomplish your purpose?
Maombi na Yesu. Yesu anaweza yote. Hallelujah. Daudi hakukuwa na kitu kikubwa ambacho alipiga nacho Goliathi. Kakale na jiwe tu kadogo ambacho alipiga nao Goliathi. Goliathi alipata kuanguka chini na kufa. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hizo shida ambazo unaona ni kubwa maishani mwako, si kubwa mbele ya Mungu. Bwana asifiwe. Hilo jambo ambalo unaona ni kubwa maishani mwako, si kubwa mbele ya Mungu. Bwana asifiwe. Jivike tu silaha ndani yako. Jivike silaha ambayo ni maombi, nayo utakuja kushinda vita. Bwana asifiwe. Nataka tu tusimame kwa shangwe na vigelegele tunapoenda kumkaribisha mnenaje. Shangwe na kwa kina vigelegele kwa kina
above our heads. There's one thing we declare that we nastahili. Nastahili kupokea utukufu, nastahili kupokea sifa. Asante ni kwa ajili ya siku ya leo. Asante ni kwa ajili ya kila mmoja ambaye ameweza kufika mahali hapa asubuhi ya leo. Mfalme wa amani, tunakushukuru, tunakuinua. Asante kwa kipindi ambacho imepita. Mungu mwenye enzi, umetupea nafasi tukakuabudu, tukakusifu. Pokea sifa mfalme wa ajabu. Hakuna mwingine kama wewe, katika jina la Yesu tunaamini.
Amen.
Amen. Yesu asifiwe. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
And
that is his nature. Wow. Amen. Just want you to wave at your neighbor. Wave at your neighbor. You can ask your neighbor how he has been. Wiki imekuwa namna gani. Amen. You know, there are some of us we met here last weekend and we are meeting here again. It has been a week, 7 days, eh? And we really thank God that he has kept us. Amen?
Amen.
And if you really thank God that he has kept you up to this far, just put your hands together for Jesus. Just appreciate God. Amen. Lord of wonders,
we glorify you.
to thank God for this week. The Lord has been good. The Lord has been faithful. The Lord has been great in my life. Amen. For the people, for those of us who are visiting us for the first time, or those of us who are wherever, I can attest that He has been a good God unto me. When I Yesu asifiwe. And that is why this morning He has again granted me the opportunity kusimama mahali hapa ili tuweze kushare His word together. Amen. I want to thank you all who are in the house this morning, and may God do you good. I also want to take this opportunity to thank our dad here and our mom for this great opportunity that they have given unto me this morning, that I may minister the word of God. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Let's just appreciate God for our parents in the house. God bless you, and God do you good in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord placed this word in my heart 2 weeks ago, I think, approximately 2 weeks ago. And I've been meditating upon this word every now and then. I really wanted to know what the Lord wants me to understand from this message. It might not be a new message. It might be a very common message to most of us. But this is what the Lord placed in my heart. Psalms chapter number 37. We are going to read verse number 1 all through to verse 4. All through to verse 4. We can read up to verse 5. Amen.
Yes. Do not fret because of evil men, or be envious of those who do wrong. For like the grass, they will soon wither, like green plants. They will soon die away. 3. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and enjoy safe pasture. Delight yourself in the Lord, and He will give you the desires of your heart. Number 5, commit your way to the Lord. Trust in Him and He will do this.
Father, we thank you for your word. In the name of Jesus Christ, thank you, Holy Spirit of God, that once again you brought your word. The Bible says that your word never comes in vain. And Father, even as I stand before your gathering, before your people this morning, I pray that, Lord, may it not be all about me, but I pray that let your power and your presence take over. I pray that, Lord, you minister to me even as you minister to your people. Speak to me even as you speak to your people, O God. Fellowship with us together this morning, Lord. I pray, Jehovah Father, that your word will not come in vain. Bible says that your word never comes in vain. And we pray this evening, this morning, that your word will not come, will not fall down, will not touch the ground until it performs the mission. Father, we thank you and we glorify your name. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I want us just to understand what the Bible says in the same book, Psalms chapter number 37. The Bible says, do not fret because of the evildoers, nor be envious of the workers of iniquity. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. That we do not fret, we should not be envious because of the works that are being done by the evildoers, by those people who are not doing anything according to the will of God. Now, when David wrote this message, this was a message that was designed for people who are in a situation that may not be according to their will. When Jesus was defeated, the situation that was could not be according to their desire. People who are in a moment of questions in their minds, when Jesus was defeated, and they ask themselves several questions. Wanasema, we have been serving God. We have been doing this. We have been committed in the works of the Lord. We have been following Christ. But how comes the few people, or many people that I know, that are not doing what is supposed to be done? They are not doing the right thing in the presence of the Lord. They are just going well. Their works are going well. Their businesses are running well. Everything they do is moving well. What could be happening? And David, a man of God, came up with this. Akasema, you should not fret. You should not be envious. Usikai like unaona what other people are doing, and then you feel that there is something wrong. When Yesu asifiwe. You compare yourself with maybe some few people who are not following Christ. You know them, even in where you stay. You know them in your family. You know them in your plot. You know them at your workplace. There are few people. They always against the work of God. Everything they do is not in line with the will of God. You know them. But if you look at what they are doing, their way seems to be right.
Then David came up with this, and anajua watu wengi, most Christians, find themselves in that situation. Wanajiona like, God, what happened? Why am I not like so and so? Why am I not able to buy a car like so and so? Why am I not able to buy plots like so and so? Why are my children not able to go to good schools like the children of so and so? Because if you compare yourself to that person, probably you feel like the other person, and maybe you feel like, God, I've been serving you, I've been committed to your ways, I've been doing this, I've been doing this right, but what is happening? Then David comes up with an answer for us this morning. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And I say, man, you should not envy them. You should not see like there's something you are doing wrong when you know you are doing the right thing. Amen. When you know you are in the right track of the Lord. When you know you are in the right will of the Lord. There is nothing wrong you are doing. You are in the right line. David is encouraging us this morning that we should not be envious. Tusiwangalie na tuone ya kwamba they are going well, and then we feel that is the right line, and then we feel that is the right way we should follow. That we should not be envious of the workers of iniquity, the workers of those people who are doing wrong, the workers of those people who are doing the wrong thing. David is specific. Anasema, do not be envious. I want us to go together. Amen. That you do not be envious of the workers of iniquity. Iniquity are sins that are performed by individuals. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Most of the time when you read the Bible, you meet these two terms. At some point the Bible talks of transgressions. At some point the Bible talks of iniquity. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I want us to understand the difference between iniquity and transgressions. Now, when David talks of workers of iniquity, iniquity are sins that are done by an individual. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. That are done by person. By me. If it is me, it is a sin that I'm the one who performs. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I go against the will of God. But transgressions are sins that are following the generations. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. From one generation to another. Maybe your grandfather sinned, and that sin is following you. The evil aspect is following you from one person to another. That is a transgression. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And that is why David is specific. Anasema, you should not be envious of the workers of iniquity. Inamaanisha, these are people we know. And we know they are not doing the right thing. See, their parents never did the right thing, though. Not that their generation never did the right thing, apana. It is themselves, they are not doing the right thing. We know them in areas where we stay. Hallelujah. And we can identify them. And there's a sense of so and so. The way he behaves, the way he talks, the way he operates, he is not a man of God. He doesn't fear God. He doesn't know God. We know them. But their ways are right. Their ways are doing well. You compare yourself to them. Unaona, mtu unasema, hii kazi yenye huyu amepata. Ni mimi ningekuwa nikwenda. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I plot yenye mtu fulani amenunua, ni mimi nilikuwa ninunue. Because God promises us good things. Amen. But now you see it is not working according to your will. It is not working in line to what your desires. But the Bible says this morning that for they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the green herb. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Now today, this morning, we just have a message of hope. That it could have been, maybe ukiangalia the ways of the enemies, the workers of the iniquity, whatever they are doing, seems to be well. But David is encouraging us this morning that do not fret. Amen. Do not fear. Do not envy them. Usiwangalie na ufikirie they are doing well. Usiwangalie na ufikirie their ways are going right. One thing you need to know at the back of your mind is that very soon they will be cut off. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And they will wither like grass. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Nani hapa anaweza penda kazi yake ama biashara yake iwither? Uamke asubuhi na unakuta your business is down. Unamka asubuhi unakuta your investment has been demolished. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. None of us would like to do such thing. Would like to experience such thing. The Bible says that do not envy them. Usiwaone na uone, hey, wewe unaendelea vizuri. No. Get that out of your mind and put your mind in Jesus. Fix your mind in the Lord. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. For the few things that we are seeing as prosperity with the evildoers, with the workers of iniquity, one very soon they will be cut off. They will wither. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Inamaanisha they are temporary things. Hallelujah. They are temporary things. They are not things to last for a long period of time. They are things to come and go. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Like grass that is that today you wake up when it is green, then tomorrow you wake up and you find it already dry. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. None of us would love to see such a thing in their lives. Amen.
Amen.
None of us would love to see your children doing well today, and then tomorrow you wake up and you find them nothing. They are totally changed. None of us would love that. So, in a manisha, whatever way that we are doing, whatever thing that we are doing, in the right line, so long as you know one thing, that what you are doing is in the right line with the Lord, you should keep doing that. You should maintain, you should persist in doing that right thing. If you know you are serving the Lord, and maybe when you came in salvation, somebody told you that when you are saved, there are a few good things that will happen. We are not saying that they are a lie. Those things are true. But one thing you need to know is that they will happen at the right timings of the Lord. They will happen at the right time of the Lord. So anything that you do, don't lose hope. Just stay on the line. Just stay in the line and ensure that so long as you are doing the right thing in that family, so long as you are doing the right thing in that workplace, so long as you are doing the right thing at that office, in that business, maintain doing the right thing.
Amen.
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 That's why the book of Romans, the Bible says that we should not be conformed by the patterns of this world. Some of the patterns of this world are evil.
Evil.
Amen. Some of the patterns of this world, the things that we see, tunaona kama ni vitu nzuri, they are evil. And so long as the Lord has opened our minds, we are able to differentiate between the right thing and the wrong. Then we should stick to the right thing. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. We should stick to the right thing. David is encouraging us this morning that these things that we are seeing, as if they are good, they are soon getting, they will be soon cut off. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. They will soon dry. They will soon wither. I would not wish to see your life withering. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I would not wish to see your family withering. I would not wish to see your business withering. I would not wish to see your education withering. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Simply because you founded your education on evil grounds. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So may the Lord help us this morning. That whatever thing that we desire, whatever thing that we pursue, anything that we follow things that are founded on Christ, things that are based on Christ, Bwana Yesu asifiwe, things that are based on the works of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Trust in the Lord and dwell in the land, and do good, and dwell in the land, and feed on His faithfulness. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Trust in the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Trust in the Lord. Can you just turn to your neighbor? Tell your neighbor to trust in the Lord. Amen. David wrote this message when times were not easy. When the situation was not good. You know, you can only be told to trust in the Lord when you are passing through a tough time.
Amen.
Some of us, when we are passing through good times, we don't even see the reason to seek the face of God. We only realize that there's a being called God when we are in tough situation. And that is why David is coming with a solution. And in that tough time, trust in the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. In that difficult moment, trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord and dwell in the land. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. You trust in the Lord. How do we trust in the Lord? By doing what the Bible has told us to do. Hallelujah. Because when we get out of the word of God, then we are it's like now we are trusting on another kingdom.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Trust in the Lord and do good. Trust in the Lord and do the will of God. Trust in the Lord and do the right thing. Trust in the Lord in that tough situation. Trust in the Lord in that condition. Trust in the Lord. And the Bible says that we trust in the Lord and never lean on our own understanding. Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
It is not easy to trust in the Lord. It is not easy to trust in the Lord. Amen.
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 It is not easy to trust in the Lord. There is a day, one of my prayer items has always been that I get out from just the normal prayer and get to a level where I will trust in the Lord and believe in the Lord when I use it. It is very easy to pray when you are in problems, but it is very difficult to trust in the Lord when you are in problems. When I use it, it is very difficult to trust in the Lord, especially when you are passing through tough time, especially when things are not working in line with your desires. It is not easy. But I want to encourage somebody this morning. Things may not be right. Amen. Things may not be well. Things may not be in line with your desire. Yes. You sat down at the beginning of 2020 and wrote down your resolutions. But yes, was if you will. In the month of April, I will be doing this. In the month of June, I will be doing this. In the month of August, I will be doing this. But unfortunately, things have not happened as you plan. But yes, was if you will. You thank God for people like Collins Vijay, who planned that they will wed and they have done it.
Amen.
We appreciate God for Vijay. Hallelujah. Vijay, it's good to see you in the house today. It was a powerful time last Sunday. Madam, you missed. It was a nice time, and you should thank God, Collins Vijay, during that tough time. The Lord has enabled you to do that.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Many people have decided to be bachelors for good.
Others are postponed.
But yes, was a few. Because of these tough times, walipanga watafanya hii, corona has swallowed everything. Hallelujah. Amen. Niliona somebody, someone in the social media, this year we have January, February lockdown. So we don't have any other months. We have January, February, and then we have lockdown. But the Lord has been faithful. Bible says that we trust in the Lord and do good. Because sometimes pressure in a kucha. I won't have anything, but the Bible says, do good in that time. But yes, was a few. Trust in the Lord and remain in the land. Dwell in the land. Hallelujah. Dwell in the land. That is where your blessings are. Dwell in the land. That is where your solution is. When I use the spirit. Dwell in the land. That is where your breakthrough is. Usiwe na wasiwasi. Usiwe na maswali. Dwell in the land where the Lord has blessed you. Hallelujah. Amen. I want to encourage somebody this morning that dwell in the land where the Lord has blessed you. Usiangaike hapa na pale. Usiwe na wasiwasi. Dwell in that land where the Lord has blessed you. And that is where your blessings are. That is where your solutions are. That is where your breakthrough is coming to locate you. When I ask you, somebody this morning, one thing you should be talking about, how long will you sustain me in this place? When I ask you, that should be your question. Our question right now should not be to be like the evildoers, to be like the workers of iniquity. When I ask you, right now, I know there's a lot of pressure. The word when I tell your son, people are looking for finance, people are looking for solutions for various problems, people are looking for several people are passing through tough times. But I told myself that even during this tough time, I will not confess that toughness. When I ask you, because one thing I know that I serve a big God. The Bible says that he who is in us is greater and bigger than he who is in them.
Wow.
Hallelujah. That is what the Bible says. That is one thing I know. And I have really tried to train myself that I will never confess defeat. Hey, corona, mambo imekuwa ngumu. When you confess that, the Bible says, what you confess, you possess.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
When you confess defeat, you possess defeat.
Yeah.
When you confess failure, you possess failure. So you should walk in faith. When people are confessing defeat, you confess victory. When I ask what's the fear. Because the Bible says victory belongs to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is where victory is, and we are his children. I want to encourage somebody this morning. During this time, during this challenging time, you need to trust in the Lord more and more. You need to trust in the Lord more and more. When people are saying, are speaking of luck, you tell them that we have a God who provides.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You tell them there's a God we serve. So the Bible says, you dwell in the land. Tell somebody, dwell in the land.
Dwell in the land.
run. Remain there in that salvation. Remain there in that walk of God. Remain there in that calling. Remain there. Hallelujah. These are the times that people are being shaped. And some are falling off. But if you trust in the Lord, Bible says, those who trust in the Lord, they are like Mount Zion that shall never be shaken. Hallelujah. Those who trust in the Lord, they are like Mount Zion that shall never be shaken. I want to encourage somebody this morning. As per the words of David, trust in the Lord and you will be like Mount Zion. Hallelujah. That nothing shall shake you. Praise the Lord. Nothing shall shake you. Nothing shall shake your family. Nothing shall shake your life. Nothing shall shake your business. Nothing shall shake your calling. When Yesu asifiwe. Only if you trust in Him. Even this time, when there's nothing you can see positive, but in that state you trust in the Lord. Amen. Even during this time, when everyone else is being pushed left, right, and center, you trust in the Lord. Praise the Lord. So that you don't wither. So that your life doesn't wither like grass. Hallelujah. I want to speak this morning briefly to somebody who is speaking, who is saying in his heart that one thing I desire, that I will trust in this Lord. One thing I desire, I will trust in the Lord no matter what, no matter the circumstance, no matter the condition. Build your foundation on Christ. Build your foundation on the Lord. Hallelujah. Build your foundation on Christ. These are the times now to identify the real Christians. These are the times now to identify the faithful Christians. David says that you trust in the Lord, dwell in the land, and do good. And then he says, and feed on his faithfulness. Hallelujah. How many of us this morning are believing together with me that we are serving a faithful God? We are serving a faithful God. Tell somebody, we are serving a faithful God. Praise the Lord. We are serving a God who never disappoints. Hallelujah. We are serving a God who never changes. Praise the Lord. We are serving a God who keeps covenant. He never changes. If you know that God never changes, if you know that He is a faithful God, then this morning I want to assure you that whatever thing that the Lord started in your life, hallelujah, He shall bring it into. Hallelujah. Whatever thing that the Lord began, the Lord is not limited. The Lord is not limited with time. The only thing that limits God is His word. What are Jesus feeling? That is the only thing that He can never go beyond. The only thing that limits God is His word. Because He can never go beyond His word. He can never fail to do His word. That is the only thing that limits Him. Akisema, He will do it, and He has just to do it. That is the only thing that limits Him. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Nothing else limits our God. He is not limited by condition. He is not limited by situation. He is not limited by your health. He is not limited by your education. He is not limited by where you stay. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. The only thing that limits Him is His word. Praise the Lord. Amen. That is the only thing. Akikumbuka, then He can never go beyond what He's saying. Hallelujah. Akisema nitakubariki. That is it. Praise the Lord. Amen. If He says you will, He will expand your territories. Look at what He told Abraham. In times when Sarah was not seeing any hope. Praise the Lord. And Abraham, I will bless you. And He surely blessed him. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. When times were beyond, God is not limited by time. We could be in the month of August. Yes. You had your several plans. Our God is not limited by anything. He is not limited by time. He is not limited by seasons. What a yes was a feeling. He knew Corona will come. Our God knew Corona will come. And He remains on the throne. Praise the Lord. He remains on the throne. God remains on the throne. And nothing will change that. He remains on the throne. And that's why David said, feed on His faithfulness. This morning, somebody, may you desire to feed on the faithfulness of But when you walk, you know I serve a faithful God. He will not leave me, nor forsake me. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Keep doing the right thing. Do not be swayed. Do not be carried away by the evil doers in the community, by the evil doers in your family. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Some of our closest friends, relatives that we knew are in they are even now piling pressure on us. That we may follow what they are doing.
Thank you, God.
But I want to pray this morning.
Oh, yes.
That we will feed on the faithfulness of God.
Yes.
We will walk in the faithfulness of God.
Amen.
He is a faithful God.
Amen.
Whatever He says, He does. When Jesus was with you, what are the promises of God on your life today? What does the Spirit speak to you? What is that thing that the Lord speaks to you this morning? That you feel the Lord is, this is mine. This is my portion. This is what is speaking unto me this morning. The Bible says, His promises are yes and
amen.
But I just want to feel it. Whatever I promise, He does. Hallelujah. Whatever the Lord promises you, He does. What makes you think that the year is coming to an end and He cannot do it? What makes you think that the Lord cannot do it in 1 month? Hallelujah. The Bible says that with our God, 1,000 days are like 1 day. And 1 day is like 1,000 days. Praise the Lord. From January to December, those are 360 something days. Bible says, God, 1,000 days are like 1 day. Namanisha, that is almost 2 years. Praise the Lord. So whatever thing that you planned, now kaeka in that plan, for a year that you want to accomplish by within a year, the Lord can do it within a day. When I Yesu asifiwe. The Lord can do it in a day. The Lord can do it in a second. He is a God. He never fails. Dwell in the land. Keep doing good. Whether you are alone, whether you are with your family, whether you are with your friends, whether you are with your workmates, whether you are with your plotmates, keep doing good. Hallelujah. Keep doing good. Do not compromise the faith. Do not compromise the word of God. Do not compromise the salvation. When Jesus was feeling. And the last verse number 4, the Bible says, delight yourself in the Lord, and He shall give you the desires of your heart. Hallelujah. Delight yourself in the Lord. Tell your neighbor, delight yourself in the Lord. Hallelujah. Delight yourself in the Lord. What is to delight? To be joyful. To get pleasure. To get happiness. Praise the Lord. That is what the devil is encouraging us to do. Instead of envying the evildoers, delight yourself in the Lord. Praise the Lord. Find joy in the Lord. Find happiness in the Lord. Find pleasure in the Lord. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
You know, many a times, what are some of the times that you feel I'm happy? You only feel you're happy when things are in line with your desires.
Amen.
And this morning, the Bible says, delight yourself in the Lord. Delight yourself in the Lord, and He shall give you the desires of your heart. What is the desire of your heart this morning? What is that which you desire? You really pray that, God, if you can do this for me. Amen. Is there somebody in the house this morning who has a desire?
Yes.
If you have a desire this morning in the house, just lift up your hands and tell God.
Oh, yes, Father. Jehovah Lord.
Fulfill the desires of my heart.
Yes.
Jesus. Fulfill the desires of my heart. And just pray that to the Lord. Ask the Lord that, God, help me to delight in you. Help me to be joyful in that situation. Help me to be joyful in that condition. Help me to rejoice. Bible says, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say, rejoice. What does that mean? There are times that we may not find reasons to rejoice. There are times when Corona pushes us to the shall fulfill the desires of your family, the desires of your children. Delight in the Lord.
My desires, God.
Delight in the Lord. Find joy in the Lord. Look at what he has done. Look at his mighty works and delight in him. Look at his mighty works and delight in him. Tell God, I will delight in your ways. I will delight in your job. I will delight in you. I will delight in you, God. Bible says, when we delight in him, he shall satisfy the desires of our hearts. The desires of our hearts could be so many. But the Lord is telling us this morning, delight in the Lord. My brother, my sister, may you find joy in the salvation of the Lord. The Bible says, the salvation of the Lord is my joy. The joy of the Lord is my salvation. This morning, I wish I can see somebody.
God.
Who has a desire?
My desire is to be
your Who has a desire?
My desire is
you know, we delight in him not because of he has given us all that we needed, but because of the gift of life we find happiness in him. Hallelujah. Tell the Lord, one thing I desire is to delight in you. One thing I desire is to find joy in you. I will not find pleasure in the things of the world. I will not find pleasure on the things of the world. I will delight myself in you. Whatever thing that you do is in line with the will of God. Want somebody this morning, just meditate upon your heart. Even as you pray that, Lord, everything that I do shall be conformed in the will of your word. Shall be in line with the desires. The Bible says that we should not be transformed. We should not be conformed by the patterns of this world. But we should be renewed by the transformation of our mind. This morning you can tell God that, God, may you transform my mind, that I will delight in you. I will delight in you no matter what. I will delight in you no matter the circumstance, no matter the situation, no matter the condition, no matter what. I will delight in you. Jesus said, my desire is to do the will of my Father. My desire is to do the will of him who sent me. I have a challenge for you this morning. What is your desire? What is your desire? What is in your heart? What is your heart's desire? The Bible says in Matthew 6 that seek first the kingdom of God. Somebody this morning, may your heart desire to seek the kingdom of God. May your heart desire to seek the kingdom of God. And everything that we need, he shall give it to us. He shall fill us with all that we need. What is the God that we serve? When we decide to line our will, when we decide to do our things in line with his will. Yes, God. And this morning, one thing I want to encourage us, that we shall not be conformed by the patterns of this world. We shall not follow the evildoers. We shall not follow the workers of iniquity. The Lord shall direct us. The Lord shall lead us. The Lord shall satisfy the desires of your family. In the name of Jesus, we are in a month of God's visitation. You can open, you can meditate upon that word. Tell the Lord, visit the desires of my heart. Visit the desires of my heart. Visit the desires of my heart. That is my prayer for you. That is my prayer for you this morning. That the Lord shall visit the desires of your heart. As he visited Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, he shall visit the desires of your heart. This month, the Lord shall not pass us by. We shall delight in you. No matter what happens, we shall delight in our God. No matter what comes our way, we shall delight in our God. I will say that everything worketh for good for those who love Christ, those who are called by his name. Are you called by the name of Christ? Are you called by the name of Christ this morning? Do you love Christ? Then you should know that thing that is happening is for good for you. That situation, that condition, that toughness, that situation, some of us, we have found ourselves between a rock and a hard place, and we feel like there's no more way out. But there is some God who makes a way where there seems to be no way. He makes a way in the way. waters of the Red Sea. He divided the waters of River Jordan. He can do it even today for you. When the children of Israel reached the river, the banks of River Red Sea, and like they saw no hope, and the enemies were coming behind them, thoroughly, the enemies were coming overtaking them, then the Lord appeared. I want you to be clear. I want you just to be clear this morning. And the Lord shall appear. The Lord shall appear. The Lord shall appear in every situation. In that situation, the Lord shall appear. Pray that that's God. You shall appear. You shall appear. The desire of my heart. The desire of my heart. I feel this one can be too personal, but the desire of my heart. We need that God. You will appear. Visit me. This month you shall appear. Somebody declare we are in the middle of August. Help us, Jehovah Father, to see your goodness. Bible says that your goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of our lives. Father, in Jesus Christ's mighty name, you spoke to David in the name of Jesus, despite the pressures that he was passing through, despite the attempts of death that Saul was trying to do upon his life. You spoke to David, and David made up his mind, and he said that even though I walk through the valleys of the shadows of death, I shall fear no evil. Father, this morning I want to pray that none of us shall fear evil, and we shall not be conformed by the patterns of this world. We shall not fear the works of the enemy. The Bible says that we shall not fear. Terrors by night shall not reach us, even all by day they shall not get into us. I want to pray this morning, Jehovah Father, that Lord, no weapon fashioned against your people, no weapon fashioned against us, even this during this time, no weapon fashioned against us shall prosper in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. No weapon fashioned against our families, no weapon fashioned against our jobs, no weapon fashioned against our parents, no weapon fashioned against our ministries shall prosper this month, shall prosper in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you and we glorify your name. One thing we pray for, Jehovah Father, and Lord, you may be with us. This morning we decide to find joy in you, to find peace in you. For one thing we know, that if you are not on our side, if you would have not loved us, if you would have not sent your Christ, if you would have not sent your Son for us, then Lord, some of us, we don't know where we could be. But we thank you for your love. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your love. Receive all the glory. Receive all the honor. Receive all the adoration. Somebody just put your hands together. Tell the Lord to receive all the thanksgiving. Give him a handful of appreciation. Thank him for who he is. Tell him, bless. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Rejoice in him. The Bible says, rejoice in the Lord. And again I say, rejoice. No matter the situation, no matter the condition, rejoice in the Lord. May you find joy. May you find peace. May you find happiness. May you find joy and grace in the eyes of the Lord this morning. In the name of Jesus, we pray. The Lord is going to visit us, and you trust in him for that. Amen. For every one of us, wherever you are, I want to welcome you to be a partaker of this word. Amen. And that the Spirit of God may visit you this week. The Spirit of God may visit you this month. Amen. And if you are there and maybe you feel this word has touched you, I want us just to pray together so that the Spirit of God may also locate you wherever you are. We respect where you are. We respect wherever you are, in your house, in your office, where you'll be watching this video from. I want to pray that the Spirit of God will visit you, and the Spirit of God will do you well. We serve a God who has ears. You know, he'll listen to the desires of your heart. He'll listen to the desires of your family. He'll listen to the desires of your business. He'll listen to your desires, the desires of your heart. One thing you just need to know, delight yourself in the Lord. Trust in the Lord, and he shall satisfy the desires of your heart. Wherever you are, just lift up your hands as we pray. And the Spirit of God shall do you well. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you and we bless your name once again this morning. We glorify your holy name because you are great. Thank you, my Father and my God. I bless you for everyone who will be watching this video, everyone who is listening to this video, wherever he is in his office, wherever he is in his house, in his business,
wherever they are, Lord, I want to pray for them, that God, this word shall be, shall have an impact in their lives. This word shall work for them. I pray that God, you will allow them not to be conformed by the patterns of this world, but they will be transformed by the renewal of their minds. Father, I pray for each and everyone who is faithfully trusting in you this week, who is faithfully trusting in you this month, who is faithfully trusting in you this year 2020. Remind them that, Lord, you are not limited by anything. You can do whatever you choose to do. Father, I thank you and I bless you. I now bless them with the blessings of Abraham. I bless them, Jehovah Father, because you are great. I worship you and I glorify your name. Thank you, God, for you never fail. And in case you are there and you want to receive Christ, also I want to give you this opportunity that you will just repeat this prayer after me and the Lord shall bless you. Lord Jesus, we thank you this morning. I come before you again. I know that I've sinned against you. This morning you reminded me of your word. Father, I now choose to follow you. I now choose to do your will. I choose, God of all glory, to take the right direction. According to what the Bible says, that you are the way, the truth, and life. Father, I pray this morning that you delete my name from the books of death and write my name in the books of life. I am saved. I'm born again in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Amen. Thank you very much. Welcome again and again. Be part of us and the Lord will bless you. If you'd like to get in touch with us in any way, there are numbers going down on your screen. You can just call at any time. You will be assisted. You will be given directions and the Lord will bless you. We are located in Nairobi. Satellite. This is satellite is in the western parts of Nairobi, and I really believe that the Lord will connect us together. God bless you and do you good.
I want to appreciate the minister who has ministered this morning. God has placed that word at a very appointed time and specific time like this one, where people are thirsting and hungering for such a word to receive. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In the same way that we have, the word has come to us, let this word find us a place in our hearts and make us continue growing toward nourishing our hearts and growing spiritually to fulfill the desires of God in our hearts.